My name is Kelly Robinson. I'm from Embedded Place of Influence, and this is Steven Siever, who's helping me out there. First of all, a little company, and we're not going to talk about the company. We do a lot of play software and ground systems. Lots of experience. We've been involved with play software way before it became TFS. I mean, we know the whole tradition. Lots and lots about it. Anyway, we really want to emphasize in this whole presentation. This is the presentation aimed towards the NASA or towards the company. It's supposed to be all open source, all open. You know, anybody can use the university or breaking the idea. We want to run the software on a light target. We want to get a real problem, potentially. A real hardware interface, like a PC and such. We want to be able to do a space flight model. TFS, obviously.
Okay, good. The our intern, Brian Anderson, came on board. I got a little bit involved with Matt Benson, Zenimai, OSAL effort. I would just kind of look it over, you know, give some thoughts, make some notes. And my intern was working on this project that Charlie described. I go ahead and instead of just using standard Linux, we went ahead and I do installation and had him actually on his Benson's OSAL. So he took the standard DFS build environment, which is just a make-base system, figure out how to bring in a new OSAL and configure build everything, and we actually had to test and ran the system under that OSAL. He didn't put a lot of effort, though, into making it a true Zenimai system. If there was, you know, so take like some application in the system and make it a hard real-time, and if you're mainly interested in DH, was a proof of concept that we could compile with Mr. Vincent Osal and have it work correctly. And that was the goal and it was successful.
We also need a ground system. We identified an open source ground system. We're usually using iPod or SIP, or even, you know, in the big ones from Raid and other companies. We picked an open source operation, set it up and running really quick. And create some simple telemetry pages and command all that really quick. One of the things actually one of our interns did, which was really great, the method that went through the document output from the CNC, created the command and telemetry database. So effectively, the bugs are up and running. And I mean, how much that would be work in a way to make this database? It's really cool to click a button and generate everything. First, we think of project would be a great start. It's a dynamic simulator. I don't know how many people here are familiar or have ever used it before. It's great. It's all open source. It's available. We're doing stuff with it. It seems like it's a really great integration system. So we're really interested in doing more with it in the future. We expect to set for it. Satellite 7000 card. It has a dual arm on it. Very light in the way of having an FPGA. You put any hardware you want in there. We have our interns do FPGA design, and she interfaces going out to the external hardware. It was really simple things, but not the start of a real project. Using this, you need, you know, the target hardware, you need an FPGA, you need the interfaces, you need the hardware, the ground system. You built up basically a starting point for a community network. You know, summer hired is a really great thing. We'll make it pushed out to the universities, make it available for everybody, and everybody brings the feedback back into the group. Little wiki, we have no, you know, have no ownership, the company has no ownership. Different wiki, that's fine. We're using, we just wanted to put something out there so we can get started. I know there was some talk about a TFP or TFL wiki and development place. We want to move our stuff there. I have no problem. It's just a matter of we need something out there. So we want something that's just open that everybody can get. I mean, whatever stuff. I mean, whenever you get up, you want to be able to bring students up and have them bring it up when they have problems or whatever problems they have, share. Everybody can get basically to the same starting point. Discord and they were basically the starters of bringing the system up the first time. We know who really don't know yet. That type of information you want to feed back in because the next kid that comes along is that they can learn from it. We want to create a solution. We create our own little web page that is out there. Very minimal content so far, but we're building on it. It's kind of how they, yeah, I don't mind moving it. It's no ownership. It's not up. The other thing is we put a lot of stuff out on GitHub. So, you know, everybody uses GitHub. Everyone's familiar with it. Creating targets with it is a great place to be. The only solution, maybe there's a better one out there. So simply, we want to create a community passing stuff back and forth, and it needs to be the whole idea, the whole project is, okay, we develop this ourselves, but, you know, somebody's going to be on it. This is their policy here. Wants to start their own program. What do they need from us? How could, you know, someone calls you and says, we're starting this program. How should I start? We want a possibility where you basically go out, buy the Zed board, down these VMs, you download the code, you get started. Tutorials, you have everything else. You have users. Now, the particulars of it are, you know, you have to determine yourself what you're trying to do with your mission, but at least in the way of using CSS and Common Tools, you have that there that allows you to get started. Because getting a whole, more than CSS, if you just send someone the code, you have to figure out how to compile it, how to put it on a real-time system, how to do all the other things. All right. And people are frustrated and not follow through. Again, we want to create an out-of-the-box solution. We want to have a wiki that shows everyone, you know, proper wiki. It's their wiki. When they find problems, they're to it. That's the whole idea of a wiki. And you want to type in a day, maybe a week, or, you know, really quick, that somebody's starting this before they get frustrated, they can actually get something working. They can cut that. They can send a command back and forth to the ground to create a telemetry page. 101 thing, but if you've ever done it before, it's a lot. Hardware running a real-time operating. That's a, you know, major chunk. That's a great starting point for somebody. And again, we want to get the community to feed back into it. And I kind of get that part of it. I'm really interested in what was going on with it. The community, one of the problems with it, there's no money. Just everybody comes up here and says, you know, the funding is this. So we're intern. We're doing it with, you know, basically free resources. Love studying it one day, probably won't ever show up. So what I'm moving forward with. I want to make sure that, you know, the student's knowledge and everything comes forward and we integrate to develop it for that. For somebody that does it, we want to get to the point where you're not just copying a code, you copy down a VM that's fully, you know, then go in and start having a where you clip and it brings up the system and it'll code, it'll do the 101, follow some simple examples. Because if someone can create a CSA app for that and create, you know, their own custom command geometry with a FPGA response, and you're going to be comfortable with the whole environment using CSS. You don't have to know an RDS right out of the box. You don't have to know how. Out of the functionality. You just do it there one day, and at least you can get it started. First of all, the poll is how many people here, is there anyone here from university, you know, that this would be interesting? Because if it is, we should, you know, get together and see how we could progress with this type of idea. And I know, conversation, they went down the same way. You know, how do you get this learning? How do you bring in new people? How do you start this from a, you know, from a new entry or coming out of college doesn't know they've never seen it before. Get them into our community. Because at least, you know, daughters, a lot of people gray hair and leaving things. 5 years, whatever. Well, get the next group to come in and take over. And I think in 1 minute, we need to come up with a good way to make this interesting. Bring in the next question.
Can I add one?
Sure.
I just wanted to, what I was really about with this whole effort with these entries we had over the summer was Brian Anderson. And he was a great guy. And he's not really a poor guy, but he has, after working with us the previous year, he actually decided to postpone graduation after a year and double major in computer science. And they mentioned another intern, Miranda. She is an electrical engineer, major. She's interested in MBA. She doesn't care about software. She doesn't really care about software.
together. They did different tasks, but this brought these three people from three different disciplines together. High school kids interested in primarily software, and they were used to something greater than their discipline, and I thought that was so cool.
That's it. Are there any questions? Good seeing you, sir.
Good seeing you. Already university, undergrad, PhD, etc., we got probably a notice system in like 2 or 3 days. The Google Faculty Research Awards, I think it was last year. Here because we want to talk about these kind of things and try to merge opportunities and try to see the collaboration.
It's a beautiful thing. Our system we've been using is the
It's not about, you know, to create a community with our name on it. The real point was to show that some core components, some standardized components with open source where that people break stuff up quickly. And it was a proof of concept to show that whatever the ultimate board is and whatever the ultimate software component is, we could create something that could be standard, that people could run, bring up fast, and help each other out. And that was really the goal. It, from my point of view as the owner of a contracting company, it's really about creating the next generation of FTE.
Ownership of it, and then we can get out of the universities. I think it could be a wonderful